In plane geometry, we have a property of circle is if two chords intersect either inside or outside, when it is produced, then product of the segments are equal. That is PA into PB equal to PC into PD. Even here also, PA into PB equal to PC into PD. This can be proved using similar triangles. Now, suppose if you have a one secant and one tangent, then PT square equal to PA into PB. Now, this you can get from the previous property. Next, one more concept is power of a point Px1, Y1 with respect to the circle is defined as PA into PB. But PA into PB is same as PT square. But PT is the length of the tangent, which is root of S1. So PT square equal to S1. So when you want to calculate power of a point Px1, Y1, you calculate directly S1. Common chord of two circles. If two circles intersect in two distinct points, the line segment joining those points is called the common chord. Now let us consider the two circles as S and S dash. Then to find the equation of the common chord, you can directly take as S minus S dash equal to zero, because common chord is a linear equation and circle is a second degree equation. If you are eliminate the first second degree terms, then you will get the first degree equation, then S minus S dash equal to zero. So 2 into G minus G dash into X plus 2 into S minus F dash into Y plus C minus C dash equal to zero. So which is the equation of the common chord. Geometrically, you can say that equation of the common chord is always perpendicular to the line segment joining the centers. Now let us prove it mathematically. So calculate slope of the line joining center C1 and C2 and the slope of the common chord. You will observe that the product is minus 1. And also, line segment joining the center C1 and C2 bisects the common chord. That is, C is the midpoint of AB only. Not necessary that it is a midpoint of C1 and C2. So, common tangent of two circles. If your line touches both the circles, then it is said to be a common tangent. You are having two types of common tangents. If both the circles lie on the same side of the common tangent, then it is said to be a direct common tangent. And the distance between the points of contact is called the length of direct common tangent. So AB is the length of direct common tangent. If two circles lie on either side of the common line, that is common tangent, then it is said to be a transverse common tangent, or another name is indirect common tangent. Now here, the distance between the two points P and Q, that is points of contact, is called the length of transverse common tangent. Now let us write the relation between the number of direct common tangents, number of common transverse common tangents under different cases. Let D is the distance between the centers of two circles C1 and C2, and R1 and R2 are the radii. Now let us consider the cases. Now first one, two circles do not intersect and one is away from the other. Now you draw the rough figure and what could be the condition, and write number of direct common tangents, number of transverse common tangents, and number of common tangents. Next, second case, two circles touch each other externally. Third, two circles intersect in two distinct points. Fourth, two circles touch each other internally. Now, we have few more cases also. Let us discuss this first. When two circles do not intersect and one is away from the other, so if you observe the figure, so the distance between the centers will be greater than the sum of the radii. So under this condition, so there are two direct common tangents and two transverse common tangents, and the total number of tangents are four. So when two circles touch each other externally, the distance between the centers equal to the sum of the radii. So under this case, there are two direct common tangents and only one transverse common tangent. When two circles intersect in two distinct points, So distance between the center will be less than the sum of the radii and greater than the difference of the radii. So under this case, you will have only two direct common tangents and there is no transverse common tangent. When two circles touch each other internally, then distance between the centers equal to difference of the radii. Because we don't know which is the bigger one, that's why we are using the modulus. So under this case, only one direct common tangent is there. And there is no transverse common tangent. Now, so let us consider few more cases. So fifth case is one circle lies completely inside another circle without any point of intersection. And one more case is concentric circles. So under these cases also write the conditions and write the number of tangents. So when one circle lies completely inside another circle, the condition is d less than modulus of r1 minus r2. Under this condition, you don't have any common tangent at all. Next, concentric circles. So d equal to 0. In this case also, you will not have any common tangent. So if the radii of two circles are different, then direct common tangents intersect each other as well as transverse common tangents also intersect each other in case if it exists. Because depending on the circles, sometimes it may exist, sometimes it may not exist. Now let us consider the case where they exist, direct common tangents as well as transverse common tangents. So these are the rough figures. So in this case, direct common tangents intersect at a point P. In this case, transverse common tangents intersect at a point Q. Now, circle equations are given. Now, mathematically or geometrically, how to get the coordinates of the point P, which is the point of intersection of direct common tangents, and Q is the point of intersection of transverse common tangents, when you know two circle equations. So from this figure, you can say that triangle PAC1 is similar to PBC2. So you can write PC1 upon PC2 equal to R1 upon R2. That is the point of intersection of direct to common tangents. If it exists, it divides the line segment joining the center C1 and C2 in the ratio of R1 is to R2 externally. In a similar manner, the point of intersection of transverse common tangents, if it exists, which divides the line segment joining the center C1 and C2 in the ratio of R1 and R1 is to R2 internally. Now, the procedure to find the equations of direct and transverse common tangents in case if it exists. So already we have discussed how to find point of intersection of direct common tangents if it exists and how to find point of intersection of transverse common tangents if it exists. That is, here P divides C1, C2 externally in the ratio of R1 is to R2 and Q divides C1, C2 internally in the ratio of R1 is to R2. That means in either of the cases, we can find the coordinates of P or coordinates of Q. After that, use the joint equation of pair of tangents using the formula T square equal to S into S1 for any one of the circle and then separate the equations. Then that becomes the common tangent. That is the first method. Now in the second method is, so here also first find the coordinates of P, R, Q and then take equation of the tangent in slope form passing through the point P, R, Q for any one of the circle. Then that will be a quadratic in M and solve the quadratic to find the slopes M1 and M2. Once you get M1 and M2, then you can write the equations of the common tangent. Now, in case if you have not remembered the equation of tangent in slope form, then what you do is take directly M is a slope and use the point and write the equation of the line passing through a point with the slope M and use the condition of tangency. that is perpendicular distance from the center to the line equal to the radius by using one of the circles and get the value of m and then calculate the equations of the tangent. So how to find the length of direct common tangent and length of transverse common tangent if it exists? So two circle equations are given. So let d is the distance between the centers and r1 and r2 are the radii. So let us consider r1 greater than r2. Then length of direct common tangent is ab. So let us derive a formula ab in terms of r1, r2 and d. In the same manner, derive a formula for the length of transverse common tangent pq in terms of d and r1 and r2. So length of direct common tangent formula is root of d square minus r1 minus r2 whole square, and length of transverse common tangent is root of d square minus r1 plus r2 whole square. So using some construction, you can derive easily. So let us draw the circle C2 inside the circle C1. Then if you observe the figure, it will be a parallelogram, and this distance between the centers is d, this also will be d, and this length will be r1 minus r2, so this will be a right angle triangle. So the ab will be root of d square minus r1 minus r2 whole square. It's in the same manner here also. So this will be a right angle triangle, and this length will be r1 plus r2, and this length will be same as distance between the center d. So length of PQ will be root of d square minus r1 plus r2 whole square.